Welcome to Break Free from Corporate, the only podcast dedicated to bringing you business success secrets from leading entrepreneurs with one thing in common. They left the corporate world, became their own boss, and are now living incredible lives. To access previous and all future episodes, visit breakfreefromcorporate.com and subscribe today.
Hello and welcome. It's Gavin Sequeira here, founder of breakfreefromcorporate.com. Glad you could join us. Today, I'm really excited to be talking to successful entrepreneur Liza Choa from Content Maximizer, who has been kind enough to share her time and thoughts with us on this podcast. Now, our aim for this episode is to share all of the tips that Liza has that has made her successful to where she is today and how you too can do the same. It's going to be an amazing podcast. I'm really looking forward to it. Thank you so much for joining us, Liza.
Thanks for having me, Gavin.
Fantastic. Now, I've known Liza for many years and have seen her develop through the years with all the businesses that she's been involved in. She has an amazing set of skills around the digital space and particularly around new and emerging technology. And she's been immersing herself with learning and understanding how we as human beings interact day to day using several forms of media available, including social media. And she's been able to harness these skills over the years to helping many organizations from single owner operator run businesses right through to large companies turning over several hundred million dollars. That's right. Her formula is simple. Help people leverage their content and reach more customers at a deeper level. Provide unparalleled service and an experience that their clients can really rave about. Now, Liza's company is called Content Maximizer. You can visit her at contentmaximizer.com. And as the title suggests, it's all about content. She is an authority on the subject of how content is created, captured, and shared, and we're very happy to have her here with us. Liza, is there anything I've left out that you'd like to add before we begin?
Wow, with that type of intro, I think you've covered everything, Gavin.
Okay, excellent. So, look, where I thought we might begin, Liza, is to just go back to where it all began. I know that you had a very promising career when we first met in the corporate world, and you were at the height of your career. You were in sales. You know, why don't you briefly share with our audience what you used to do, just in a nutshell, and what made you get into the mode of wanting to start your own business, and what possessed you in wanting to take such a different step in direction?
Sure. Well, the last job that I had, I was with a global software company and I was in a business development role. I was looking after accounts such as all the government departments in Australia, or the hospitals and all the universities. I had a fairly big budget of around US $5 million per year that I had to bring in for the company. So that was a bit of stress that I was under. I was fortunate that, you know, I had a pretty good boss. He let me do what I want. I can work from home. And the perks that you get working with a major corporation, you get the corporate Amex and you get all your expenses paid and all the travel. So it was pretty good. But at the same time, I've always had an entrepreneurial spirit. I could always see possibilities. And what really got me to want to do more is because I know that I could do more. And unfortunately, I knew I wouldn't be able to express that in the corporate world. The other aspect is the stress that I was under. I remember coming to the office one day after my gym session at lunch, and this thought went in my head, which was, oh my gosh, this is going to kill me one day. And I knew that I had to do something.
Yeah, look, I can really appreciate that. I came from the corporate world myself, and it is very high pressure sort of work. And, you know, you constantly have to go in and perform at a very high level. There's really no breaks, is there?
No, and you're only as good as your last month's figure. Mm. And, you know, and I guess I just wanted more, and being able to have the freedom, and that's what I really wanted. And I always have ideas and you know, business ideas that I always want to try out. And to a certain degree, I found having that corporate role quite restrictive.
Yeah, look, it's really interesting you say that. Did you find that while you were in your corporate job, you didn't really have the freedom to express your creative side in terms of, you know, doing something different? Did you find it was an environment that really you had to keep your ideas hidden and to a large degree suppressed?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it was in an environment that, you know, that people want to play it safe. They don't want to be too different. And at the end of the day, because I was in the business development role, all people really care about were the numbers. Everything else is secondary. And I'm very much a creative person. So, yeah, I just found it, you know, to be restrictive, and I wanted to express that creativity.
Yeah, look, I hear what you're saying, and I can tell you a lot of people I've spoken to, and I've spoken to quite a few hundred people over the last few years, a lot of people in corporate roles or in jobs in general really share the sentiment. And look, what I want to do is direct you now, I guess, in a certain direction where I know a lot of our listeners are battling with a few issues, and I thought we could tap into some of these if it's okay with you.
Sure.
Now, one of those issues is, when it comes to running a small business, there's a lot of negativity in the marketplace. You know, people hear stories of, you know, businesses closing down for sale, for lease, you know, 95% of businesses fail in the first couple of years, all of those sort of negative statements. And it kind of puts people off wanting to even try to get into business. And then they look at their job as, you know, security. But we all know how secure and unpredictable that can be. You know, what are your thoughts around this? And I guess, how did you mentally prepare for your transition when you decided enough was enough? What did you do?
Yeah, look, that's a really good question that you've raised there. I didn't jump into the entrepreneurial space cold. I actually had a plan. So I started a business on the side, and it took me around 18 months before I could make the transition. So my recommendation to anyone who is considering leaving their corporate role and starting something on their own is to have a plan. You know, whether it is the amount of savings that you have and how, like, how much runway do you have? You know, so if you have no income, how long would that last you? Or, you know, you can start off with building something on the side until it reached to a point where your income is equal or exceeds at least your expenses. I mean, the income that I had when I made the transition didn't totally replace the income that I was on when I was in the corporate world, but it was enough that covered my expenses plus more for me to make that transition. So I think it's really important to plan that properly. Mm-hmm. And yeah, during the transition period where, let's just say, you've got two things going, whether it's your job and your business on the side, it's going to be, you know, a bit of hard work, and you know, you need to manage your time really well. But then it's also a really good opportunity for you to test your business idea to see whether it is really viable, whether it can actually produce income before you jump into it. Because the last thing you want is jump into something that is not a viable business idea.
Yeah, some really, really good thoughts. You actually mentioned quite a few gold nuggets. And then I guess one of the things that stood out and from my perspective was the fact that you had a plan and you made a transition. You didn't just jump off the deep end, you know? And,
no.
Yeah.
It was an 18 months transition period, like I mentioned. And it got to a point where I so wanted to leave that I was willing to do whatever it takes to make it work, to accelerate that time as quick as possible. And for me, that was 18 months.
So for 18 months or maybe longer, you were unhappy in your actual job. Is that it?
I mean, look, I was very grateful to have a job, and I had a very good boss. So I was very fortunate in that regard. But it was how I felt was like this bird in a cage, and I can't wait to fly, and that's what got me going. It's more the pleasure of possibility rather than the pain of where I was really drove me to take the consistent action that I did.
Fantastic. Okay, well, I know that'll be very heartening, I guess, for some of the people listening to this, because there are people who are in positions where it's hard for them to see another way out. And I guess it does require a bit of careful planning, because this is a major step for a lot of people to have to do. And it's not something you want to take lightly, and you do need to prepare for it. Now, I have another question for you. in going in this new direction, which, you know, is a brave new world and you stepped out into it, I bet everything wasn't smooth sailing. And I know that, you know, sometimes things do go wrong quite often and not how you quite planned it or how you envisioned it was going to turn out. So how do you cope when, you know, things don't quite turn out the way that you plan? What's your way of dealing with that?
Yeah, great question. And I think it all comes down to attitude. Mm-hmm. And I've got two words that I could think of. The first one is being able to laugh at situations. I think that is really important. And then secondly is being adaptable. Wow. I think one of the key of being a successful entrepreneur is the ability to be adaptable to situations. So when things happen that is not what you plan, then you got to go, okay, where do I go from here? And the ability to be creative, to be adaptable and find solutions, because I believe that whenever there's a will, there's always a way. So it's really about your mindset and your attitude.
Yeah, look, I totally agree. I think that's really good advice. And sometimes it's easier said than done to smile and be happy in times of adversity and when the economy's not good and there's things like the GFC that hit a few years ago and things like that. But it really does come down to attitude. You're absolutely right. Now, this may sound like a silly question, but I know that in the midst of when you did your transition, there were some tough times, I'm sure. And talking about things like the GFC and the industry slowing down and all that, you know, were there times when you just thought, what the heck am I doing? And should I just throw in the towel, give up now and just go back to what I know works and just forget this silly pipe dream of mine? Were there times that you ever felt in that position?
No.
Okay. Well, tell me this. What kept you going?
I just knew that there would be solutions. So, you know, there was a period of time where my business was going down, you know, during the GFC, and it was tough. And what I had to do was, you know, I went and got a part-time job to support my income while I kept my business going. So for me, it wasn't about going back to corporate. It's about how can I make this work? Mm. And because I was so far into it and I love what I do, then that I think that is really important too, is that you have to love what you do in order for you to be able to keep going when things get tough. So once again, it's really just, you know, about being creative and finding solutions. So, but going back to corporate, no, that would just take up too much of my time.
Yeah. So it's interesting you said that you were pretty much prepared to do whatever it took, and you were so far into making this work that you were even prepared to take a part-time job just to keep the cash flow going so you could support your dream of your business. Is that right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, fantastic. So I'm going to fast forward now to the present, because this is all stuff that happened quite a few years ago. But now that you are where you are and you're in a different position today, how has life changed since you started your business? I mean, through all the ups and downs you've gone, where are you today? What's your life like today compared to when you first got on this journey?
Well, definitely the freedom that I have now, you know, being able to get up, not by the alarm, but because I naturally wake up, you know, that to me, I feel is a gift every single day. Recently, you know, a good friend of mine messaged me. He was rushed into hospital, had a major operation, and he needed someone to be there. And I was there. And I felt very blessed that I could be there rather than, you know, if I was at a job, I need to ask my boss or ask someone whether they would allow me to be there. So having that freedom to choose what I do, when I do, is a real blessing. The other thing that has changed for me now is just totally loving everything that I'm doing in my business. I see it kind of like a blank canvas. Yep. Where I can paint and express my creativity. So having the choices of doing that to me is a real blessing. So I mean, like every day I kind of like, you know, smack myself in the head and go, wow, is this real? to go to the gym in the middle of the day when it is not busy and, sure. and have a workout. So things like that, or being able to travel around the world and once again not needing to ask for annual leave.
Yeah,
that
sure.
that is that's things that was worth the sacrifice.
Yeah, look, it definitely is. And freedom, I think, is what everyone deep down craves. So, and as you've been going through this journey, what would be three things that you've had to really learn? And it's not something that you've mastered, but you've continually had to improve on as a result of running your own business, if you had to name three.
That's a really good question, Gavin. Mm-hmm. One of the biggest challenge I had when I left my full-time job was I had so much time. And I had so much freedom that I was losing the routine
yep.
and discipline.
Mm-hmm.
So I think to be successful in business, what's really important is to have discipline.
Yeah.
And it sounds a bit, what's the word, contradictory, because you know, we talk about freedom, right? And yet now we talk about discipline.
Sure.
But I have now learned that in order to continue having freedom long term, you need to embrace discipline. And that is something that I continue to learn and to embrace. So that's one thing. The second one is, which kind of goes with discipline, is planning.
Yes.
Being able to plan ahead, whether it's your time, whether it is your goals, you know, the direction that you want to take your business. So planning, I feel, is really, really important. And that's something that I continue to develop over time as well.
Sure.
And then the third one that I found challenging is, like, now I've got a team of staff that I work with. And there are times when you have to let people go. So being able to build the emotional muscle to let people go, yeah, it's one that I had to learn as well.
Yeah, that must be a tough thing, I guess. It's not personal, is it? It's really, this is about outcomes in your business at the end of the day.
Yeah, and because, you know, I do appreciate people and what they do, but then when there isn't a good fit, you kind of feel bad and you don't want to let them go. And so
yeah.
being able to build those muscles to have those conversations to let people go, and it's better for the business and for them in the long run.
Yeah, really good points. And I'm sure you are getting better and better with each day, with each of those areas, and there'll probably be other areas that you're working on as well. But I'm sure that these are things that all our listeners would love to improve on as they grow their business or they get into their business. These are just areas that are going to require a lot of effort. Fantastic. Now, here's an interesting question. I want to know, because you seem like a very positive person, okay? And I don't know where you get that from. A lot of people, like I said in the past, coming out of the corporate world, sometimes people come out for various reasons and they're very apprehensive, they're very nervous. It's hard to be optimistic. A lot of people tell them different stories. And I want to know, with you being in your business now, you are your own boss. What inspires you each day? Do you have like a mantra or a set of things that you say to yourself when you wake up in the morning? Or do you do certain regular things like go for a run or do yoga, meditation? Like, what keeps you inspired each and every day?
What inspires me is the freedom that entrepreneurship brings. I am extremely grateful for that freedom that I now have. Just having that flexibility totally inspires me.
Okay. So just the fact that you have the ability to make choices that perhaps in the past you couldn't make uh-huh. is what inspires you.
Yeah, totally. Mm-hmm. And I go to the gym every day. I enjoy having a workout and having a sweat. Not so much, you know, meditation. That's mm-hmm. something that I aspire to doing. But
yeah.
every time I meditate, I end up falling asleep. So,
yeah,
just having the freedom to do what I love. And the thing is, with me running the business that I have, which is in the digital marketing space, it allows my creative juice to flow. So I just love every moment of it.
Sure, sure. I bet there's not enough hours in the day for you to actually express this freedom of yours that
yeah.
you've created. Yes.
That's right.
Okay, fantastic. Well, now here's something, and I think you kind of alluded to it. Surrounding yourself with some successful people that share similar ideals as yourself, it's not an easy thing to do. And we always hear the fact that you are the product of your environment and you should surround yourself with people that you want to be like, etc. So when someone is leaving the corporate world, I mean, obviously they're leaving that place because maybe they don't see a future for themselves in there. How do they then find the right people for them to hang out with or to be like? How did you do that? And could you share with our audience, how are you able to attract so many successful people, fun people into your life these days? What's your secret?
Yeah, I think in this entrepreneurial journey, it can be quite lonely for some people. The environment that you surround yourself with is absolutely crucial. When we talk about environments, I think there are different aspects. There is the environment in terms of what type of information and what type of message do you surround yourself with. So for me, I immerse myself in listening to podcasts. So Gavin, I think the podcasts that you are putting together where other people in the corporate space that want to start their own thing, I think this is the perfect environment that they can immerse themselves in so that they are in the right environment, the right headspace, listening to other stories of other entrepreneurs who've been in the corporate, going into their own business and hearing their story. That I think is really important. Mm-hmm. For me, is listening to podcasts, listening to CDs, reading books. I'm also part of a few forums of other like entrepreneurial forums. Yep. So the people that are in those forums, they're all business owners as well. So then right. We speak the same language, we've go through similar challenges, so we can bounce ideas off each other. I go to a lot of seminars as well. And when you go to seminars, meeting those people, you start developing a new group of friendships.
Yep.
And with that, people that you have a connection with, you stay friends with. So then that become part of your support environment. I also have a coach that I work directly with. So he has got 25 years of experience ahead of me. So having a coach really makes a difference also as part of the environment that you're talking about. So anyone who is looking at, you know, leaving corporate, going into their own business, I think it is absolutely crucial to surround yourselves, whether it's mentally or physically, to be in the environment where there are other people who are either going through the same journey that you've gone through or they are already ahead of you.
Sure.
That can give you some guidance. That definitely makes the journey a lot easier.
Yeah, look, and I think there's a lot of really great things you just brought up there, which is, even if you don't know a single person at this point in time, and it is lonely at that point, you can go and find the right people, and they're available in networking groups, in, you know, face-to-face functions, in online forums. You mentioned even through listening to podcasts, you don't need to physically know someone. You can still surround yourself with people by listening to information online or watching videos and listening to CDs. So there's multiple ways, really, isn't there?
Yeah, and especially now with the internet, I mean, anything that you can think of, you can pretty much find it online. So just Google it and you'll find forums, you'll find books, you'll find podcasts, you'll find meetup groups. You know, they're just everywhere. You just got to go out there and look for it.
Yeah. And look, for anyone listening to this particular podcast and the one that we're doing now, and I know there'd be a lot of people thinking, yeah, but it's, you know, she did it because she had a certain type of skill set that enabled her to do it. I'm very shy, or I'm not a people person, or whatever it might be. Now, what would you say to them? Can anyone who's listening to this with enough desire and commitment to their future, can they make the decision to break away from their job and one day become their own boss? I mean, what would you recommend they start to do?
You got a few questions there.
Yeah.
So your first question is, can anyone with the desire go and start their own business, be their own boss?
Yes.
So my answer to that is, I think it takes more than desire.
Mm-hmm.
I think it takes discipline.
Sure.
To do that, because it is so easy after, you know, a hard day at work, when in the corporate it's a lot of stress, it's so easy to come back home where you're tired and you go, oh, I'm just going to watch TV, I'm just going to chill out, and then not taking the action that is required to build your business. I think it takes more than desire. I think in order to be successful in running your own business, you definitely require discipline and consistency. If you've got the right attitude, you've got the desire, you've got the discipline and the consistency, then yes, I believe anyone can run their own business, leave the corporate and be their own boss. In terms of your next question, which was where do they start? What is the action step that they should take? It depends on what type of business do they want to start, whether they even have an idea for a business. My recommendation is do your research, validate the idea. And the best way to validate the idea is to get someone to pay for it. Right. You know, that's the best form of validation. Then you know what, if you can get someone to pay a dollar, then you know that you've got a business. If no one's willing to pay for it, or if you're too scared to ask for the money, then it's not going to change when you leave your corporate job. Definitely do your research, validate your idea, and start asking for money.
Okay, wow. Well, yeah, no, and fair enough. And those are key things that anyone who's looking to go down this path would have to do this. You know, it's mm-hmm. almost a must. Now, you've shared a lot of great nuggets for our listeners. I want to turn this more now into a fun section of the podcast. And I call this section the rapid response section. So there's not a lot of time for you to think, but I'm going to hit you with five really quick questions. And the first thing that comes to your mind, I just want you to say, you good to go with that?
All right, let's go.
Okay. So what is your favorite mode of learning, video, audio, or books?
Audio.
Okay, great. Give me three words that describe how it feels to run your own business.
Freedom.
Yep.
Responsibility. Creativity.
Fantastic. Okay, great. Now, here's a good one. Morning person or night owl, and why?
Definitely night owl.
Okay.
I am so much of a night owl that in the morning when I wake up, I miss breakfast, I go straight to lunch.
Okay, so I guess for the second part of that question, why?
Why? I find that it's a lot more quiet and it's a lot more peaceful at night, mm-hmm. so I can focus and do what I want to do. Later in the evening, I do most of my creative work at night.
Okay, which is encouraging for people who work in a full-time job. They can always spend some of their evenings to get started on their business.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, next question. Uh-huh. Favorite role model or hero and why?
Oprah Winfrey.
Okay, that's interesting. And why Oprah Winfrey?
Her humanitarian approach, not mm-hmm. even approach, just who she is. She's so philanthropic. But then also when you know her background and how she's overcame the odds that she had with her upbringing and her racial background, etc. Mm-hmm. But following her passion, believing in herself and just keep moving forward, being one of the highest paid personality in the US. Yeah, and yet she has got a lot of challenges, but she still stay grounded, and yet she is so giving, so she inspires me.
Fantastic. And she's really someone who has overcome a lot of personal barriers that would have held most people back, and she's just proven that with, like you said, enough persistence and determination and consistency, she's been able to rise to the top.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So I can see a little bit of Oprah Winfrey in you, perhaps. No, that's fantastic. That's great.
Thank you. I'll take that as a compliment.
Yes, definitely. Now, fast forwarding into the future, as a business owner, you would have a vision for your future and for your business. What lies ahead for Liza Choa? Where do you see yourself and where do you see your business going over the next 3 to 5 years?
Yeah, so the focus in the next 3 to 5 years is to grow Content Maximizer, systemize the business a lot more so that we can get more customers, you know, benefiting from what we've got to offer. And in order for the business to grow, you need to systemize. So that's where we're at now and see how we can fine-tune what we do to add more value to our customers.
Fantastic. And just touching on that point, the fact that, you know, you have this kind of vision allows you to be able to grow the business, because without a vision, you really don't know if you're moving forward or backwards. Is that right?
That's right. I mean, vision is very, very important, because if it's your business, then you're the captain of the boat.
Excellent. And so you're the captain of your boat. Brilliant.
That's right.
Yeah. Look, Liza, I just wanted to thank you. You've really given us some great ideas. I know I've learned a few things as well, especially the consistency side of things. It's probably an area that I can work on a lot more in my business. You've given plenty of food for thought for our listeners to work with, and we really appreciate your time. So thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, brilliant. Folks, for more information about Liza Choa and her business, Content Maximizer, please visit contentmaximizer.com. If you like this podcast and would like to understand a little bit more about what was just discussed, then you're in luck. Simply head over to breakfreefromcorporate.com and we have a fantastic bonus gift waiting for you to download. All we ask in return is that you leave us a review on iTunes and or Stitcher, whichever you use. And lastly, help us share this podcast around with your friends, your colleagues, through Facebook, Twitter, Google+, or LinkedIn. We truly appreciate all your support, and we look forward to seeing you on the next episode.
Thank you for listening to this podcast episode of Break Free from Corporate. Once again, to access previous and all future episodes, visit breakfreefromcorporate.com and subscribe today.